Hello and welcome to the WBAP 820 570 KLIF Weather Podcast for Thursday, October 20th, 2022. I'm Chief Meteorologist Brad Barton from the Cumulus Media Center in Dallas-Fort Worth. Well, we were able to enjoy a couple of days of real fall weather earlier in the week. We even saw temperatures fall to 33, 34 degrees along the Highway 380 corridor from Denton to McKinney. But we're going to be getting windy and much warmer again through the upcoming weekend, and then we're looking for some storms possibly on Monday. All right, our morning satellite loop shows nada. Nothing out there. Just a beautiful, beautiful day. The high temperature in Dallas-Fort Worth is supposed to get into the lower 80s today. It'll be a little warmer farther to the south, but all in all, winds are relatively calm. The skies are cloud-free. And that's why we say fall is some of the nicest 3 weeks of the year in North Texas. The only rain on the national radar picture today is kind of a mix of rain and snow up in the Great Lakes. Some of it's rain, some of it's snow. Pretty chilly temperatures over the eastern third of the nation. And we got some of that cold front again a few days ago, but all in all, it's going to be windy and much warmer for the Dallas-Fort Worth area this weekend. Okay, let's look at the surface weather models from the Global Forecast System. What you're seeing there is a storm system that essentially shut down parts of Alaska earlier this week, and it takes a lot to do that. It is a powerful Pacific storm system that's going to dive on the lower 48 and then hook back up into Canada. And its effect on us will be a quick round of showers and storms farther south on Monday, the 24th of October. But the real business end of that storm system will be in the northern tier of states and in the Great Lakes. While it will produce some quick rainfall in DFW on Monday, it could actually produce some severe weather around Kansas City and Omaha and Des Moines, but not likely here in North Texas. Okay, let's start moving through the surface forecast maps. By Thursday night, there's a little lake effect snow over Lake Ontario and parts of upstate New York and a few scattered storms around Miami, but that's really about it. Not much anywhere else. By Friday morning, the leading edge of that Alaskan storm system is now putting down some rain and snow in the Pacific Northwest, parts of Idaho and Montana. By Saturday, that storm system has become a pretty big deal. Lots of rain over the Pacific Northwest, reaching into North Dakota, and a lot of snow and ice in some of the northern Rockies, especially around Idaho. Now, by Sunday, that storm system has really gotten wound up with a tight circulation over northwest Colorado and heavy snows over the higher elevations affecting parts of Utah, Yellowstone National Park, the northern half of Idaho. And check out the pinwheel effect. The prefrontal trough becoming occluded in Nebraska, the purple front near Scottsbluff, Nebraska, actually. A big warm front over the Midwest, a secondary warm front extending from the leading punch of that storm system from South Dakota clear on up into Canada. And then two more surface lows from South Wyoming down to about Las Vegas. It is a whale of a low-pressure storm system with barometric readings probably, well, nearly as low as a hurricane, covering an area 10 times bigger over parts of 10 western states. And notice all those isobars, the lines of equal pressure. That's why we're going to have such gusty winds for the next several days in North Texas before the trailing front finally gets through here. Now, as it moves northeast, it starts picking up Gulf moisture, and on Monday, that's when we expect to get our rain here in North Texas. At the same time, a much weaker Atlantic storm system is producing a little bit of rain in New England, and then back to the west again to secondary storm system in the northwest, the Pacific Northwest, trailing its big brother. And by Tuesday, the center of the storm system is well up into Canada, but the frontal boundary is setting off scattered rains now from the Gulf Coast all the way to the Great Lakes. We call this a full latitude front. It runs from Canada all the way down to Mexico. So it's a pretty big storm system for sure. Now on Wednesday, the next Pacific storm system has started to fire up again, and we see some routine showers are active over the trailing front of the eastern third of the country. And Thursday looks really, all in all, pretty quiet. So here's our forecast. From the WBAP Weather Center, sunny, breezy, and mild, high today 83, winds kind of shifting around from north to southwest back to north again, and it'll be a fairly cool night with lows 50 to 54. Now, tomorrow, Friday, is when we get windy and warmer. We're going to have high near 90 with gusty southwest winds, and really, that's not going to be good for your allergies. That's not going to be good for dust, pollen, that sort of thing. And also, we're getting back into some fire danger because we haven't had any rain in some time now. The ground's very dry. Again, we're still in a condition of drought, so fire danger is going to be increasing throughout the weekend. Saturday up to 88, south winds up to 30 miles an hour. What a day for a picnic, huh? And on Sunday, 87 for the high, a few clouds, a little more humidity, but again, south winds 20 to 30. And then finally, by Monday, will be mostly cloudy, windy, and mild with a few scattered showers and storms. Won't amount to much, half an inch of rain, but we'll get something out of that. And the temperatures will finally back off with highs in the 70s and lows in the 50s. Well, thank you very much for joining us for the WBAP 820-570 KLIF Weather Podcast for Thursday, October 20th. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye. Hello, and welcome to the WBAP 820-570 KLIF Weather Podcast.